It's baseball time from Mary Lou Retton Park. The Polar Bears of Fairmont Senior playing host to the Wildcats of Pendleton County. I'm Eli Brady here to take you through the action today. And after a long week of rain and cancellations for the Polar Bears, they're back in action today versus Pendleton County. The Polar Bears 8-1 on the season. The last game we covered live here was Buchanan Upshur. They won that one 12-6. They went on four straight road games, and they won all four against Weir, Oak Glen, Preston, and Liberty. The Pendleton County Wildcats come in at 7-3. They started their season off 5-0. They've been 2-3 since then. Struggled. They lost to Kaiser and Musselman, came back and won against Moorfield and lost to Tigard's Valley. We'll have the starting lineups when we return. You're watching live streaming coverage of Polar Bear Baseball here on Video Productions.
National Bank, where you can purchase or refinance your home with the no down payment champion mortgage. No down payment, no private mortgage insurance, no kidding. Visit your local branch to get started today. City National Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. To learn more, log on to mortgage.bankatcity.com.
Here at the Cracker Barrel, homestyle food and great value go hand in hand with favorites like slow simmer chicken and dumplings starting at $7.99 or perfectly golden fluffy buttermilk pancakes with your own bottle of warm syrup. Come fill up on favorites without emptying your wallet. Cracker Barrel, take care now.
Little General Stores has been serving West Virginia communities for almost five decades. That's nearly 50 years of providing those essential needs for your daily journey. We are so grateful to be a small part of your lives, and we want to recognize the integral part of our operation, the LG family. We know these last couple years haven't been easy, but with every sunrise and sunset, you keep us going. To the LG family, the moms, dads, sisters, brothers, sons, and daughters of West Virginia, thank you.
You have a goal. You know what you want. Start with us, New River Community and Technical College, your community college. Take classes online or in a classroom in Beaver, Lewisburg, Somersville, or Princeton. Or step outside the classroom in one of our technical or health programs. Find flexible and affordable options to help you reach your goal. It's closer than you think when you start with us. New River Community and Technical College. Apply today.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park. Getting ready for the announcement of the starting lineups, the umpires and coaches meeting at home plate. It's 53 degrees here in Fairmont. It'll raise to about 57 degrees throughout the game. Sunny. Weather shouldn't be a factor. However, the past week's weather will be. The torrential rain we've had the last 2 days here in Fairmont has soaked the field, and that will be a challenge for the fielders, as they're going to have to play really aggressive when fielding baseballs hit on the ground in the infield and the outfield. A lot of moisture on the ground. Marion County schools, in fact, were closed yesterday to flooding, so a lot of rain has come down, but it's sunny right now. Field hopefully will dry up as the game goes on, but the early innings are going to be a little bit tough for the fielders. Go ahead and take a look at the batting order for first Pendleton County. Leading off will be Alden Rexroad, followed by Chase Owens, James Vinsel, Cashton Kizemore, then Dylan Smith, Cole Harper, Caleb Armentrout, Dusty Smith, and Josiah Kimball round out the starting lineup for the Wildcats. And for the Polar Bears, leading off as usual will be Cam Peschel, followed by Sammy Vianney, Logan Canfield, Dylan Hours, moved up from 9-4 since the last time we've been live here. Brody Whitehair batting fifth, then Ethan Miller, Brock Martin, first time he's starting here at home, transferred from North Marion a few weeks ago. Braden Gorby will follow him, and Hayden Jones batting in the ninth spot will round up the lineup for the Polar Bears. in the field for Fairmont Senior. We got Logan Canfield on the mound pitching today. Ethan Miller will be his catcher. Hayden Jones starting on first. Gorby at second. Brody Whitehair at shortstop. Sammy Vianney at third. Dylan Hours out in left field. Cam Peschel in center. And Brock Martin in right field. For the Wildcats of Pendleton County, starting pitcher will be Chase Owens. His catcher is James Vinsel. Cole Harper on first. Caleb Armentrout at second. Alden Rexrode at shortstop. Dylan Smith at third. Dusty Smith in left field. Josiah Kimball in center field. And Cashton Kizemore out in right field. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, we'll hear the announcement of the starting lineups here on Video Productions.
Hi, my name is Zach Frazier, and I'm from Fairmont, West Virginia. And when I'm back at home in Fairmont, you'll find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that Golden Boot Pride at Parmar. There are literally hundreds of Parmar stores in West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, and even more on the way. Download the Parmar app to save even more. And whether it's food, gas, groceries, or whatever, we have you covered at Parmar. West Virginia proud and ready to serve you.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
An injury at any age can be a game changer. But with walk-in clinics Monday through Saturday, the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute is ready to get you off the bench and back in the game. Marshall Sports Medicine Institute takes care of the hurt.
For your matchup today, Fairmont Senior versus Pendleton. Starting lineups for Pendleton. Number 15, Alden Rexrode. Number 5, Chase Owens. Number 10, James Vinsel. Number 16, Cashton Kizemore. Number 20, Dylan Smith. Number 8, Cole Harper. Number 12, Caleb Armentrout. Number 1, Dustin Smith. And number 14, Josiah Kimball. And now the starting lineups for Fairmont Senior. Batting first, number 3, Cam Peschel. Number 1, Sammy Vianney. Number 2, Logan Canfield. Number 5, Dylan Hours. Number 7, Brody Whitehair. Number 4, Ethan Miller. Number 6, Brock Martin. Number 27, Braden Gorby. And number 24, Hayden Jones. Now please rise for the national anthem.
Since 1965, the team at City Construction has been an industry leader in all facets of construction, shaping the West Virginia landscape with some of the most recognizable commercial projects throughout the state. As one of the largest general contractors in North Central West Virginia, our outstanding record of quality workmanship and personal service is here for your next project. Call our team of experts today.
Give us the opportunity to design and build your next project. City Construction Company, West Virginia proud since 1965.
Here at the Cracker Barrel, homestyle food and great value go hand in hand with favorites like slow simmered chicken and dumplings starting at $7.99 or perfectly golden fluffy buttermilk pancakes with your own bottle of warm syrup. Come fill up on favorites without emptying your wallet. Cracker Barrel, take care now.
City National Bank, where you can purchase or refinance your home with the no down payment champion mortgage. No down payment, no private mortgage insurance, no kidding. Visit your local branch to get started today. City National Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. To learn more, log on to mortgage.bankatcity.com.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park, getting ready for the first pitch, which will come from Logan Canfield, who's made one start on the season, picked up a win in four innings pitch. That was against Buchanan Upshur, which was the last game we were live here, but that was five games ago. Logan allowed eight hits, four walks, struck out three batters in the 12-6 win over the Buccaneers. Leading off for the Wildcats of Pendleton County will be Alden Rexrode. Again, the wet field could be a challenge for these infielders today. Canfield deals the first pitch up high inside for ball one. Canfield, the lefty. On the mound, the 1-0. Up high inside for ball two. Count is 2-0. Nobody on, nobody out. Canfield kicks and fires. That one catches the strike zone for strike one. Canfield steps back on the mound. Here's the 2-1. Inside, ball three. Getting sunny day. Weather shouldn't be a factor, but it's the past weather that has soaked the field. Keep an eye on the 3-1. That one up high, ball four, and Rexrode is on. He is walked. That'll bring up Owens for Pendleton County.
Now batting number five, Chase Owens.
Owens will be starting on the mound today for the Wildcats. One on, nobody out. Pitch from Canfield, and that one's on a line into center field. It is down in front of Peschel, and a base hit for Owens. Two on, nobody out for the Wildcats.
Now batting number 10, James Vinsel.
James Vinsel comes to the plate looking to do some damage for Pendleton County. Two on, nobody out, top of the first. Again, strong wind gusts as well. That one in the dirt for ball one. Fairmont Senior wearing all black today. Pendleton County wearing dark blue and light blue uniforms, very similar. Here's the 1-0, and that one catches the strike zone for strike one. Count is 1-1. James Vinsel, two on, nobody out for Pendleton County. Pendleton County is single A. They are 7-3 on the year. The Polar Bears are double A. They are 8-1. That one fouled by Vinsel down third baseline. Again, big wind gusts. In this one, Polar Bears looking to try to win their seventh in a row. Started this streak back in the East Fairmont game. That one is over the head of Whitehair into left center field. Here comes Rex Road to the plate. Pendleton County is on the board as it gets away from Vianney. 1-0 Wildcats. You see the replay there. Pendleton County is getting a hold of these pitches. An RBI single for Vinsel brings up Cashton Kizemore, and there's still two on, nobody out. Runners on first and second, and Pendleton has a 1-0 lead. Pitch from Canfield catches the strike zone for strike one. Rex Road has come in, batted in by James Vinsel. Kizemore at the plate. Two on, nobody out. The 0-1. That one is grounded to Whitehair. Could be two. Flip to Gorby, to Jones, and it's a double play. So there is a positive there for the Polar Bears. So we'll take a look. Whitehair was able to get in front of that one.
Now batting number 20.
Field it cleanly. Flip it to Gorby, who threw it to Jones for the double play. Runner now on third base with now two out in the top of the first inning. The runner is Chase Owens at third. Vinsel was out at second, and Kizemore was out at first. Dylan Smith at the plate for Pendleton with a runner in scoring position at third. One on, two out, and this one is into left center field. Ours gets underneath and makes the catch. And the Polar Bears get out of the inning, only allowing one run. Watching live streaming coverage of Polar Bear Baseball here on Video Productions.
Hi, this is Meredith Mayer from Fairmont, West Virginia, and when I'm back home, you can find me at my local Parmar store.
We have that thundering herd pride at your local Parmar stores. We are over 200 stores strong and growing. Download the Parmar app for even more savings and sign up for the Parmar Rewards Card. Whether it's food, gas, or groceries, we have you covered. We are Marshall and we are Parmar Stores.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
Here at the Cracker Barrel, homestyle food and great value go hand in hand. With favorites like slow simmer chicken and dumplings starting at $7.99. Or perfectly golden fluffy buttermilk pancakes with your own bottle of warm syrup. Come fill up on favorites without emptying your wallet. Cracker Barrel, take care now.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park. The Wildcats get on the board first in the top of the first inning. They lead 1-0. Leading off for the Polar Bears will be Cam Peschel. Following him will be Sammy Vianney and Logan Canfield. On the mound for the Wildcats is Chase Owens. Take a look at the season stats for Cam Peschel, who will be leading off batting .414 on the season with 12 hits and 13 runs scored. And adding six RBIs to that, a very impressive start to the season for Cam Peschel. This is the 10th game of the year for the Polar Bears. They are 8-1 and one of the favorites in Class AA. Owens getting his last couple pitches in. This will be the last one. Catcher for Pendleton County will be James Vinsel. First baseman, Cole Harper. Second baseman, Caleb Armentrout. Shortstop is Alden Rexroad. Dylan Smith at third. Dusty Smith in left field. Josiah Kimball in center field. Cashton Kizemore in right field. That is the fielding positions for Pendleton County. This is their 11th game of the season. They are 7-3 on the year. They started off 6-0, 1-3 in their last four games. And their schedule has gotten tougher, and it's gotten even tougher today as the Polar Bears have been red hot their last six games, six consecutive wins. Peschel steps up to the plate for Fairmont Senior. Pitch from Owens in the dirt for ball one. Wind starting to pick up. And it is heading out towards the outfield. As I'm looking at the flag in center field, it is moving away from us. Count is 2-0 for Peschel. 2-0 from Owens, down the middle for strike one. Here's the 2-1. Swung on and grounded, going to be a tough play. Rexroad fields it. Throw to first, not in time, and Peschel is safe. There's the first time we've seen today that grass slowed the ball down, made Rexroad have to charge it. He got there late, and the throw to Harper was not in time. And Peschel will have a base hit. So one on and nobody out. Sammy Vianney up for the Polar Bears. Shows bunt. That one's in the dirt. Gets away from Vinsel, and Peschel stays put on first. Take a look at the season stats for Vianney. Batting 250 with seven hits, five runs, five runners batted in. Owens checks first. Peschel, a threat to steal. He's got a lot of stolen bases this season. And that's a big part of his game. He can get from first to second, second to third really, really well. One on, nobody out. The 1-0, and Vianney showed bunt again and missed it. And that'll be strike one. See, Vianney has showed bunt the first two pitches. Let's see if he goes back to it on the third one. Peschel with a big lead at first. Vianney fouls that one back into the press box. Off the netting in front of the window here. Good thing that netting is there. So he fouled it back for strike two. The count is 1-2. One on and nobody out. Pitch from Owens, swung on, ground. Another tough play for Rexroad. Has to charge it. Throw to first, and that's not in time. Peschel takes off from second. He gets to third. Everyone's safe for the Polar Bears, and it's runners on the corners. That foul ball from Vianney knocked the camera off the netting. But Peschel gets from first to third. Vianney has a base hit, and back-to-back ground balls to Rexroad. He's not able to charge it in time. The Polar Bears have runners on the corners for Logan Canfield. Nobody out in the bottom of the first inning. Fix that camera behind home plate. Vianney takes off. The throw to second is in time, and Vianney is caught stealing. Little surprise, Peschel didn't try to take off to home there and try to do the old double steal. He stays put at third. And now there's one on and one out. Peschel in scoring position. The count is 0-1 to Logan Canfield. Pitch from Owens. Off-speed pitch, misses outside for ball one. Heschel on third, waiting to come home to give the Polar Bears their first one. That one fouled back by Canfield. The count is 1-2. Count is 1-2, one out, one on. Pitch from Owens is high for ball two. Good eye from Logan Canfield, not taking a swing on that and chasing it. Misses high again, and the count is full. Bottom of the first inning, one on, one out. The payoff pitch, and Canfield lines it into left field. Peschel comes in. It's his 14th run of the season, and the Polar Bears tie at 1-1 in the bottom of the first on an RBI single from Logan Canfield. Full count. He swings, hits it perfectly into left field. Peschel's able to come home. Now,
Alex, you got a different batter.
Now, some confusion here. Originally, the lineup, what we have up here, has Hours in the fourth spot, but it's Brody Whitehair at the plate. Hours on deck. Whitehair. And interesting here, Whitehair lined it, and it was caught in the air by the third baseman. We'll take a look at the replay. So Whitehair lines out right there. It's caught. You can see Canfield on first, caught in between. They try to throw back for the double play. And they say Canfield, that's Tyler Veltri on first as a courtesy runner. So Veltri slid back in time safely. And now there's some conversation. So Whitehair is out, because Dylan Smith caught it. And now they say Veltri's out. And a double play for Pendleton County after discussion ends the inning. Tied 1-1 here on Video Productions.
Hi, my name's Zach Frazier, and I'm from Fairmont, West Virginia. And when I'm back at home in Fairmont, you'll find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that Golden Boot Pride at Parmar. There are literally hundreds of Parmar stores in West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, and even more on the way. Download the Parmar app to save even more. And whether it's food, gas, groceries, or whatever, we have you covered at Parmar. West Virginia proud and ready to serve you.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
An injury at any age can be a game changer, but with walk-in clinics Monday through Saturday, the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute is ready to get you off the bench and back in the game. Marshall Sports Medicine Institute takes care of the herd. Let us take care of you.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park. And
he said he switched it on both sides except for you guys.
Okay, I just want to make sure. Thanks.
Some controversy to end the bottom of the first inning. So the lineup has switched for the Polar Bears. Whitehair is now batting in the fourth spot. Dylan Hours is now batting in the fifth spot. And that's not the only thing, as we'll go back and take a look at that last play. Replay, we'll slow it down. Whitehair, and that is caught by Dylan Smith at third. Smith realizes he caught it in the air and it didn't take a bounce. You can see Veltri, the runner, way off first base, trying to slide back in time. Smith throws it, Harper makes the catch, and after discussion, it was initially a rule that Veltri was safe and it was only one out. After discussion, they called Veltri out and the Wildcats get a double play to end the inning. So that's what happened there. Now we're starting the top of the
now
second inning.
Number eight, Cole Harper.
Leading off for Pendleton County to start this inning will be Cole Harper. Looks like we got everything sorted out. Canfield deals the first pitch, and that one's outside for ball one. Score tied 1-1 in the top of the second inning. Count is 1-0. Pitch from Canfield. That's on a line into right center field and a base hit for Harper. So Harper leads off with a single to start the second inning. Brings up Caleb Armantrout for the Wildcats.
Caleb Armantrout.
Coach for Pendleton County calls time. And there's a discussion going on down third baseline between two Pendleton County players and head coach. And they return. Paul Harper returns
work
the first.
Work down here, work down.
Armantrout to the plate for the Wildcats. Nobody out. One base runner for Pendleton County. Canfield checks first. He deals. Showing bunt and now trying to throw it back to first. And out. At first is the call. Cole Harper tagged out by Hayden Jones. And the quick reaction from Ethan Miller to get the ball to first base. See Harper off the base throw to Jones, and Jones gets down for the tag in time. And there's one away with nobody on. Count is 1-0. And that one catches the strike zone for strike one. Here's the 1-1 inside, and they call it a strike. Catches the inside of the strike zone. Count is 1-2 for Armantrout. Wind picking up, the 1-2. Canfield goes off speed, misses high for ball two. Nobody on, one out. The top of the second inning, score tied 1-1, 2-2. Swing and a miss. Armantrout strikes out. First strikeout of the day for either team. And there's two away in the top of the second inning. Dustin Smith coming up to the plate for Pendleton County. Nobody on, two away. Off speed goes right down the middle for strike one. Smith stands in, the 0-1, swung on and fouled back on the ground. The count is now 0-2.
Thank you, sir.
Miller comes out to talk with Canfield. Dustin Smith is the batter for Pendleton. He goes and talks with his third base coach. Top of the second inning, score tied 1-1, nobody on, two outs. Count is 0-2. Canfield strikes out Smith, back-to-back strikeouts for Canfield, and that ends the top of the second inning. We'll have the bottom of the second coming up next when we return here on Video Productions.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
An injury at any age can be a game changer. But with walk-in clinics Monday through Saturday, the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute is ready to get you off the bench and back in the game. Marshall Sports Medicine Institute takes care of the herd. Let us take care of you.
I'm Keith Powell, and going on right now is my Keith Says Yes Fest. I'm saying yes to lowering your payments, yes to your trade-in, regardless of condition, miles, even if you're still making payments. My Keith Says Yes credit approval process helps me say yes, you're approved. So if you want new Chevys, yes. New Fords, yes. Lifetime warranty, yes. Come see me, Keith Powell, at Yes Chevy in Hurricane and Yes Ford in Huntington.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park. Leading off this inning for the Polar Bears will be number five, Dylan Hours. Take a look at his stats on the season. It's one of the most impressive. 11 hits, 7 runs, 11 RBIs, batting 500 on the year. And he's moved up. He used to bat in the ninth spot.
Number five, Dylan Hours.
Moved up. Supposed to start in the fourth spot today. Got moved back to the fifth spot before the game. 11 RBIs. He also has a grand slam on the season. Checks with the first base umpire. They say Hours went around for strike one. Here's the 0-1 from Owens. Catches the strike zone for strike two. Count is 0-2. Nobody on, nobody out. Pitch from Owens. Swung on, and it's fouled back high into the air by Hours. Count remains 0-2. The 0-2 from Owens. Misses for ball one.
Go, Dill.
Owens deals the 1-2. Swung on into right center field by Hours. And that one is down. It's behind Kizemore. Hours the second. Hours is going to go to third. And it is a lead off triple for the Polar Bears. And Dylan Hours adding to his impressive stat line to start the year.
Now batting your catcher, number four. Ethan Miller.
Kizemore was going back, and he couldn't get there in time, went all the way to the track. Hours goes all the way to third and a leadoff triple to start the inning. Brings up Ethan Miller for the Polar Bears. Good time to try and send Hours home to give the Polar Bears the lead. Swings and misses there. It's strike one. The 0-1, swing and a miss by Miller. Strike two. Nobody out, one runner on. It's Dylan Hours at third base. Great opportunity here, drive in a run. That one misses in the dirt. Hours stays put at third as Vinsel's able to trap it. Count is 1-2. This will be pitch number 24 for Owens. Canfield also has 24 for the Polar Bears. And Miller swings and misses and strikes out. First out of the inning. Brings up Brock Martin. Newer addition to the team. He only has 7 plate appearances. He's got 3 hits, 2 RBIs, looking for his 3rd RBI. Try and give the Polar Bears a 2-1 lead. Martin fouls it back. Count is 0-1. Brock Martin transferred to Fairmont Senior from North Marion before baseball season started, after basketball season ended. He's a junior. The 0-1 misses outside for ball one. Base runner on third for the Polar Bears with one on and one out. Dylan Hours trying to come home to give the Polar Bears the lead. That one fouled back by Martin. The count is 1-2. Count is 1-2 for Martin. Pitch from Owens, misses outside, ball two. A couple of times today, Chase Owens has had the Polar Bears in a count 1-2 and given up hits. Count is now 2-2. Pitch, a swing and a miss by Martin. He strikes out. Back-to-back strikeouts for Owens after allowing the leadoff triple by Hours. Brings up Braden Gorby to the plate.
Now batting your second baseman, number 27, Braden Gorby.
Gorby batting 278 on the season, 5 hits, 5 runs, 4 RBIs. One base runner is Hours at third. 2 outs. Owen steps off the mound, puts Hours back at third, gets his lead again. Here's the pitch. It's down low for ball one to Gorby. Tie game 1-1, Hours at third. They try to pick him off and Hours is back in time. Wind really starting to pick up now. Big gust coming through. Count is 1-0 for Braden Gorby. Here's the pitch, and Gorby, this one is high into center field. Kimball underneath it. Kimball makes the catch. The inning is over. And the Polar Bears strand Hours at third. And Wildcats get out of the inning. Score still tied, 1-1. You're watching live streaming coverage of Polar Bear Baseball here on Video Productions.
Hi, my name is Zach Frazier, and I'm from Fairmont, West Virginia. And when I'm back at home in Fairmont, you'll find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that Golden Boot Pride at Parmar. There are literally hundreds of Parmar stores in West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, and even more on the way. Download the Parmar app to save even more. And whether it's food, gas, groceries, or whatever, we have you covered at Parmar. West Virginia proud and ready to serve you.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
An injury at any age can be a game changer. But with walk-in clinics Monday through Saturday, the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute is ready to get you off the bench and back in the game. Marshall Sports Medicine Institute takes care of the herd. Let us take care of you.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park. Getting ready for the top of the third inning. Leading off for Pendleton County will be Josiah Kimball. Made the catch in center field in the bottom of the second to end that inning. And then it will go back to the top of the order. After Kimball will be Rex Road and Owens. Canfield getting his last pitch in. Ball has been put in play a lot in this game for both teams. Score tied 1-1. Entering the box is Josiah Kimball. Trying to start the third inning off hot for Pendleton. Pitch from Canfield. Misses low for ball one. Here's the 1-0. Canfield delivers, curving into the strike zone for strike one. Beautiful pitch from Canfield there. Here's the 1-1. Swing and a miss by Kimball. Count goes to 1-2. Kimble steps back in. Canfield looking for his third straight strikeout. 1-2, a swing and a miss, and he gets it. Kimble strikes out. One away, nobody on. Brings up Alden Rexrode for the Wildcats.
Now batting number 15, Alden Rexrode.
Rexrode walked in the first inning. He is the only run that has come in for Pendleton County. This Canfield pitch misses high for ball one. The 1-0. Misses barely, and it's ball two. Count is now 2-0. Two oh pitch from Canfield, misses inside, and it's a 3-0 count for Alden Rexrode, trying to get on base for the second time today. Down the middle for strike one. Rexrode watched that one, hoping it would miss. It did not, and the count is now 3-1. One out and nobody on for Pendleton. That one catches the inside corner. The count is now full. Canfield has struck out three straight batters, looking for four. The payoff pitch down the middle for strike three. Canfield strikes out Rexrode looking. It's a 3-0 count, three straight strikes.
Now batting number five.
And there's two away.
Owens.
Nobody on. Brings up Owens. Had a base hit in the first inning. Canfield looking for his fifth straight strikeout. Down the middle. Strike one to Owens. O-1 count. Two outs, nobody on. Pitch from Canfield is fouled off by Owens. He's got an 0-2 count. Odds are looking good. The 0-2 misses down low for ball one. Canfield had three strikeouts in four innings against Buchanan last time he was on the mound. He's got four strikeouts in three innings. The 1-2, up high for ball two. Two from Canfield, and that one misses outside. The count is full again. Payoff pitch, a swing and a miss, and Canfield strikes out the side in the top of the third inning. Five straight strikeouts, and Canfield getting hot from the mound. Score still tied, 1-1. Bottom of the third inning coming up next here on Video Productions.
Hi, this is Meredith Mayer from Fairmont, West Virginia, and when I'm back home, you can find me at my local Parmar store.
We have that thundering herd pride at your local Parmar stores. We are over 200 stores strong and growing. Download the Parmar app for even more savings and sign up for the Parmar Rewards Card. Whether it's food, gas, or groceries, we have you covered. We are Marshall and we are Parmar stores.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
Here at the Cracker Barrel, homestyle food and great value go hand in hand, with favorites like slow-simmered chicken and dumplings starting at $7.99, or perfectly golden fluffy buttermilk pancakes with your own bottle of warm syrup. Come fill up on favorites without emptying your wallet. Cracker Barrel, take care now.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park. Score tied 1-1 as we enter the bottom of the third inning. Due up for the Polar Bears will be Hayden Jones leading off. followed by Cam Peschel and Sammy Vianney. Take a look at the season stats from Hayden Jones, batting 240 on the year with 6 hits, 6 runs, and a pair of RBIs. Looking to improve that stat line at this at-bat. In a close game. 4 road games for the Polar Bears since the last time they've been here. They defeated Weir 9-6, Oak Glen 7-5, beat Preston County 3-1. They 10-run to Liberty 12-2. Improved to 8-1 on the year. It's been the opposite for Pendleton County. They've been in a slump. Started off the season 6-0, 1-3 in their last 4 games. Pitch to Jones, and that's a base hit into left center field. And Jones is on with a leadoff single. One pitch to Hayden Jones, and we got a base runner, nobody out.
Cam Peschel.
Cam Peschel steps up. He had a base hit in the first inning. He came in. He represents the Polar Bears' only run in this one. Pitch from Owens, and Peschel bunts, and it's a good one, but it curves foul at the last second. That could have been trouble for Pendleton County, as it looked like it was going to stay fair, but it clipped the grass and it sent it left. Foul ball, and the count is 0-1. Coach Reiser thought that one was staying fair, too. He wanted it. It's a perfect bunt. Just caught a blade of grass that sent it off direction. One on, nobody out. Count is 0-1, and that pitch is in the dirt. Hayden Jones is the base runner for the Polar Bears at first. Peschel is the batter. 1-1 count. And Peschel has another base hit as it is down in front of Kimball. Jones gets to second. Brings up Vianney. Take a look. Jones was waiting between first and second. Make sure it wasn't caught by Kimball, but it got down in time. 2 on, nobody out. Back-to-back base hits for the Polar Bears. Vianney had a base hit in the first inning, got caught stealing. 2 on, nobody out. Pitch from Owens up high for ball one. Base runners are Hayden Jones at second, Cam Peschel at first. Showing bunt is Vianney. He lays it down in front of Owens. Owens tries to turn to second, and not in time. Peschel is safe at second. The bases are loaded. Nobody out in the bottom of the third inning. Polar Bears turning to the bunts.
Now batting your pitcher, number 2.
Owens had the easy out at first. Chose to try and get Peschel out, and it did not work. And the bases are loaded. Nobody out in the bottom of the third inning. Brings up Logan Canfield. Owens. Down the middle for strike one. Very tough situation here. For Pendleton County, the Polar Bears are threatening. And that one is hit in the air by Canfield. Caught by Kimball. Jones tags. He takes off. No throw from Rex Road, and the Polar Bears have the lead on an RBI from Canfield. Sends Hayden Jones home. It's 2-1.
Batting your shortstop, number 7, Brody Whitehair.
Two on, one out. Base runners at first and second. Pitch to Whitehair, misses up high and inside. Hayden Jones is the one who came in. Peschel, base runner at second. At first is Vianney. Runners at first and second. Count is one and one with one out. Peschel takes off to third. The throw is... And Peschel is safe as third baseman Dylan Smith missed the tag. So Peschel has a stolen base.
What's count, please?
You can see the throw, and Peschel makes a move, misses the tag. He's safe at third. Runners on the corners. One out in a 2-1 game. Count is 1-1 to Whitehair. The pitch from Owens misses in the dirt. Peschel takes off to the plate. He's safe. Fairmont up 3-1. Vianney gets to second as well. Two runs have come in, and Peschel scores on the wild pitch. Count is 2-1 for Brody Whitehair. With one on and one out. Here's the pitch down the middle for strike two. Only one out still for the Polar Bears. Count is 2-2 to Whitehair. Pitch is in the dirt. The count is full. Polar Bears still have a runner in scoring position. It's Vianney at second. Payoff pitch. Misses low. Whitehair is walked. He's on. Two base runners. Only one out, bringing up Dylan Hours.
Dylan Hours.
One of the most dangerous hitters on this team. He had a triple in the second inning. He's got two runners on with only one out in the bottom of the third. Bears up 3-1. That one in the dirt for ball one to Dylan. Pitch from Owens, swung on. That one's in the air. Moving over is Armin Trout. He makes the catch in fair territory for the second out of the inning. Hours pops out, brings up Ethan Miller.
Your catcher, number four, Ethan Miller.
Two on, two out. Miller struck out in the second inning. Trying to at least add another run to the board. That one in the strike zone for strike one. Welcome you back to Mary Lou Retton Park. Had a little bit of network issue there. Hopefully it fixed. You saw a lag in the stream. Hopefully get that fixed. A little bit of internet issues, but we're back. Count is 3-0. Canfield delivers that one in the zone. Batter is Vinsel. 3-1 count to Vinsel. Pitch from Canfield is fouled back. Start of the top of the fourth inning. The Polar Bears are up 3-1, and Vinsel now has a full count. Payoff pitch from Canfield misses. And Vinsel is walked. Canfield had 5 straight strikeouts until then. Walks Vinsel, brings up Cashton Kizemore.
Now batting number 16, Cashton Kizemore.
One on, nobody out for Pendleton County. They trail by 2 in the top of the fourth inning. Base runner is Vinsel. Pitch from Canfield, a swing and a miss by Kizemore. Veltri throws back to first, and it's an out. Tyler Veltri with the throw to first, and Hayden Jones with the tag. Vinsel is out, one away, nobody on. Canfield delivers that one high. The count is 1-1 to Kizemore. One out, nobody on now. New catcher for the Polar Bears is Tyler Veltri. A swing and a miss there by Kizemore. Or no, it is Ethan Miller. Okay, Veltri was the one warming up. They must have changed while we were resetting the live stream. So it was Ethan Miller with the throw to first. Number is blocked by the umpire from here. Count is 2-2. One out, nobody on. Pitch from Canfield is hit on a line by Kizemore into left center field. Peschel underneath it. And no, he dropped it. Peschel with the drop. Peschel dropped it in left center field. And Kizemore reaches on the error to second.
Now batting number 20, Dylan Smith.
Brings up Dylan Smith. Flat out in the first inning for Pendleton. Base runner at second for the Wildcats. It's Kizemore. One on, one out. Smith at the plate. The pitch from Canfield inside, ball one.
Snow strikes here.
Wind really picking up. Field has looked to dry out since the start of the game. Water is evaporating as this game goes on. The 1-0, a swing and a miss by Smith. Pitch from Canfield is down the middle for strike two. Count is 1-2 to Smith. One runner on, one out in the top of the fourth inning. Polar Bears lead 3-1. Here's the 1-2 from Canfield, a swing and a miss. Smith strikes out. Strikeout number 6 of the day for Canfield. And there's 2 away. Brings up
number 8.
Cole Harper, first baseman for the Wildcats. One on, two outs. Canfield steps off the mound. Sends Vinsel. Sends Kizemore back to second. Kizemore is the runner. That one in the strike zone for strike one to Harper. Lefty to lefty here. The 0-1, a swing and a miss by Harper. O2 count, one on, two outs. Here's the pitch, a swing and a miss. Seventh strikeout of the day for Canfield, ends the top of the fourth inning. We have the bottom half of the inning coming up next when we return here on Video Productions.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
An injury at any age can be a game changer, but with walk-in clinics Monday through Saturday, the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute is ready to get you off the bench and back in the game. Marshall Sports Medicine Institute takes care of the herd. Let us take care of you.
I'm Keith Powell, and going on right now is my Keith Says Yes Fest. I'm saying yes to lowering your payments, yes to your trade-in, regardless of condition, miles, even if you're still making payments. My Keith Says Yes credit approval process helps me say yes, you're approved. So if you want new Chevys, yes. New Fords, yes. Lifetime warranty, yes. Come see me, Keith Powell, at Yes Chevy in Hurricane and Yes Ford in Huntington.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park. Turning to the mound is Chase Owens for Pendleton County. Leading off for the Polar Bears this inning will be Brock Martin, followed by Braden Gorby and Hayden Jones. Martin struck out in the second inning. Comes back up to the plate. In the bottom of the fourth inning, the Polar Bears lead by two. The score is 3-1.
Now batting your right fielder, number six, Brock Martin.
Pitch from Owens to Martin. Swung on and fouled back over the press box. Count is 0-1. Pitch from Owens. That one is grounded. Picked up by Armantrout. The throw to Harper in time. And Martin grounds out. First out of the fourth inning. Braden Gorby up next for the Polar Bears. Pitch from Owens. Misses low. Ball one.
Now batting your second baseman, number 27, Braden Gorby.
Count is 1-0. Here's the pitch from Owens, and Gorby grounds it. And it gets by Rex Road, and Gorby is on. Goes under the glove of the shortstop, Alden Rex Road.
Now batting your first baseman, number 24, Hayden Jones.
Braden Gorby reaches on an error by Rex Road right here. He had it, good position on it, and gets by him. Hayden Jones coming up to the plate for the Polar Bears. Pitch from Owens, misses inside. Jones had a base hit in the third inning, came around and scored later on in that inning on an RBI by Canfield. Here's the pitch, and this is into left center field by Jones, and it is down and past Kimball. Here comes Gorby. He gets the third, runners on the corners.
Now
Now we go.
Another base hit from Jones. Puts the Polar Bears in scoring position.
Now batting, your center fielder, number 3, Cam Peschel.
Brings up Cam Peschel for Fairmont, who has 2 base hits in this game, and he's scored 2 runs. Makes him have 14 hits and 15 runs scored on the season. Good ratio there. Runners on the corners, only 1 out. Here's the pitch from Owens. Misses low. Count is 1-0. And time called. And there's going to be a meeting at the mound for Pendleton County. Trying to calm down Chase Owens as he's in another tough spot. He's been here before. Only 3 runs scored for the Polar Bears. There's definitely opportunity to score more. He's had the bases loaded with no outs. We've got 1 out, 2 on. Pitch to Peschel. That is grounded to Rex Road. He throws to Harper. That's in time. Gorby's in for the score. So it's an RBI for Peschel. He is out, though. Jones gets the second. Gorby comes in, and the Bears lead 4-1.
Number 1, Sammy Vianney.
One on, 2 outs. Vianney is the batter. Hayden Jones is the base runner at second. Here's the pitch from Owens. Down low. Misses. To Vianney. And he steps back in. Owens checks Jones at second. Here's the pitch, and it is fouled back by Vianney. Scoreboard not working out in left field here at Mary Lou Retton Park, trying to get that fixed. Pitch from Owens. Misses in the dirt. Count is 3-1. Here is the 3-1. Catches the outside corner for strike 2, and the count is full. One on, 2 out. Here's the payoff pitch, and Vianney fouls it back. Count remains full. Vianney has 2 singles in this game. Count is full. The payoff pitch is swung on, and that is right to the second baseman, Armin Trout. He gets it to Harper in time for the 3rd out of the inning. Not before the Polar Bears could drive in a run. They now lead 4-1 here on Video Productions.
Hi, my name is Zach Frazier, and I'm from Fairmont, West Virginia. And when I'm back at home in Fairmont, you'll find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that Golden Boot Pride at Parmar. There are literally hundreds of Parmar stores in West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, and even more on the way. Download the Parmar app to save even more. And whether it's food, gas, groceries, or whatever, we have you covered at Parmar. West Virginia proud and ready to serve you.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
An injury at any age can be a game changer, but with walk-in clinics Monday through Saturday, the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute is ready to get you off the bench and back in the game. Marshall Sports Medicine Institute takes care of the herd. Let us take care of you.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park. Polar Bears lead the Wildcats of Pendleton County 4-1, getting ready for the top of the fifth inning. Due up for the Wildcats will be the 7-8-9 hitters, Armin Trout, Smith, and Kimball. Logan Canfield at the mound for the Polar Bears, who's had an excellent game to this point. He's only allowed 2 hits in this game, 7 strikeouts, and 1 walk. So the Wildcats have done damage in the first inning, but since then it's been all Polar Bears. Pendleton started this game off up 1-0, 4 unanswered runs for Fairmont Senior. Up to the plate will be Caleb Armentrout. Start the fifth inning. Pitch from Canfield, down the middle for strike one. Armin Trout struck out in the second inning in his only plate appearance to this point. Has an 0-1 count from Canfield, and that one bounces short of the plate for ball one. Count is 1-1. Armentrout fouls it back, makes the count 1-2. Nobody on, nobody out. Count is 1-2. Canfield gets the signal from his catcher, Ethan Miller. Here's the pitch, and that one inside for ball two. Here's the 2-2. Down the middle for strike three, and Armin Trout strikes out looking. Third straight strikeout for Canfield. That's the second time he's done that in the game, gone on these strikeout streaks.
Now batting number one, Dusty Smith.
Had a streak of 5 earlier in the second and third inning. Here's the pitch. That one misses up high for ball one. The 1-0, that one grounded. It's fair, throw by Vianney, and it's not in time to Jones as it goes off the glove and over the head of the first baseman, Hayden Jones, and it's a base hit for Smith, Dustin Smith. He's on, that's the first base hit for the Wildcats since the second inning.
Josiah Kimball.
One on, one out. Brings up Josiah Kimball, who struck out in the third inning. Ump calls time.
Give me a sec. While he's got time, I figured I'd take his care of this.
And third base coach of Pendleton County meeting with his players. Kimball steps back in for the Wildcats with one on and one out. Here's the throw to first by Canfield, keeping the base runner Smith honest. Here's the pitch, and trying to lay down a bunt is Kimball. He fouls it back, and the count is 0-1. Canfield throws back to first. Trying to pick off Smith.
Really?
Count is 0-1. Here's the pitch. That one is called strike two. On the inside corner to Kimball, who showed bunt again, pulled back, but it was in the strike zone.
You'll get it.
Here's the 0-2. Swing and a miss. Another strikeout for Logan Canfield. Kimball strikes out. That is number 9 on the day for Logan Canfield. Two outs, one on. We're back to the top of the lineup for the Wildcats. It's Alden Rexrode, who walked and scored the only run for the Wildcats in the first inning and struck out in the third inning. And this one is into right center field. Brock Martin is underneath it, and Martin makes the catch. Had to extend a little bit for that one, but he hauls it in, and the Polar Bears will flip it to the bottom half of the fifth inning. You're watching live streaming coverage of Polar Bear Baseball here on Video Productions.
Hi, this is Meredith Mayer from Fairmont, West Virginia, and when I'm back home, you can find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that thundering herd pride at your local Parmar stores. We are over 200 stores strong and growing. Download the Parmar app for even more savings and sign up for the Parmar Rewards Card. Whether it's food, gas, or groceries, we have you covered. We are Marshall and we are Parmar stores.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
Here at the Cracker Barrel, homestyle food and great value go hand in hand, with favorites like slow-simmered chicken and dumplings starting at $7.99. Or perfectly golden fluffy buttermilk pancakes with your own bottle of warm syrup. Come fill up on favorites without emptying your wallet. Cracker Barrel. Take care now.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park, getting ready for the bottom of the fifth inning. Polar Bears lead 4-1, and the Wildcats of Pendleton County have decided to switch pitchers. They bring in Cashton Kizemore, who started in right field. He's now on the mound. Chase Owens went to shortstop to replace Rexrode, and Rexrode went to right field to replace Kizemore. So those are the fielding changes for Pendleton County. They trail 4-1 to the Polar Bears. Kizemore getting some warm-ups in.
Now batting your pitcher, number 2, Logan Canfield.
Canfield will be the batter for the Polar Bears leading off this inning, followed by Brody Whitehair and Dylan Hours, trio of football players. In the third, fourth, and fifth spot in the lineup. Here's the pitch from Kizemore and misses outside for ball one. Count is 1-0. Kizemore deals down the middle. Count now 1-1. Nobody on, nobody out. Kizemore deals. That one misses outside for ball two. Here's the 2-1 from Kizemore. Up high, ball three. Canfield stands in. Here's the 3-1. Misses and Canfield walks. So Kizemore steps to the mound and he walks his first batter face. One on, nobody out. Brings up Brody Whitehair. Brody has lined out and walked in this game. We got a courtesy runner on first for Canfield. It'll be Tyler Veltri is the courtesy runner. Nobody out, one base runner. Veltri courtesy ran in the first inning and was out on the throwback from third to first after Whitehair lined out. A little bit of controversy surrounding that play. Kizemore pitches to Whitehair, misses up high for ball one. Veltri has a couple stolen bases on the season, so he is a threat to take off. Kizemore deals the 1-0. That one catches the inside corner for strike one. Whitehair crowded the plate, had to move out of the way. They called it strike one. Count is 1-1 with one on and nobody out. Kizemore deals. Whitehair shows bunt. That one misses for ball two. Turned out to be a really good day here in Fairmont. Field is dried up a little bit. Here's the pitch. Whitehair grounded. That's in the left field and past Smith. A base hit from Whitehair, and there's two on, and nobody out. Brings up Dylan Hours.
Now batting your left fielder, number 5, Dylan Hours.
Whitehair with the base hit. Two on, nobody out. Base runners are Tyler Veltri at second and Brody Whitehair at first. Dylan Hours is the batter. Had a triple in the second inning, and he popped out in the third. Pump fake from Kizemore there gets Veltri back to second. Here's the pitch to Hours, and that one is called strike one. Last time we were live here, we had Dylan Hours have a grand slam. In that one, he's got an 0-1 count with two on and nobody out in this one. And he shows bunt, lays it down. Kizemore charges it. Throw is in time to Harper, but the runners advance. Hours is out. Runners on second and third, two in scoring position now for Ethan Miller.
Now batting your catcher, number 4, Ethan Miller.
1 out, 2 on for the Polar Bears. Ethan Miller at the plate. Veltri, the base runner at third. Whitehair, the base runner at second. A pitch from Kizemore. Another bunt attempt is in the air and down in front of the press box for strike one. Pitch from Kizemore, and that one is into center field. And it is caught by Kimball. Tagging and taking off is Veltri, and Tyler Veltri scores. The Polar Bears lead 5-1. On the RBI by Ethan Miller. Miller is out.
Now batting your right fielder, number 6.
Whitehair also tagged. He got to third. 2 outs, 1 on. Brings up Brock Martin. Here's the pitch from Kizemore. Swung on. That's grounded. Tough play for Owens. He can't get it. Whitehair's in with the score. And Martin gets the first. Chase Owens, the new shortstop. He couldn't field that one. And Martin gets the first. Another run is in for Fairmont. It's 5. It's 6-1. Whitehair walks across the line. Gorby comes to the plate now. where he talks with Coach Reiser, third base coach. Martin is the base runner at first. One on, two out. Bottom of the fifth inning, they try to pick off Martin, and he's back in time. In a 6-1 game, Polar Bears have pulled away. They trailed 1-0 in the first inning, six unanswered. Pitch from Kizemore, called strike one to Gorby. Big wind gust at the moment. The count is 0-1. And trying to see if they call it a foul ball. Yeah, it hit the bat of Gorby, and the count is 0-2. One on, two outs. Count is 0-2 to Gorby. Here's the pitch from Kizemore. Misses way outside for ball one. Kizemore checks Martin at first, deals the 1-2, swung on and grounded by Gorby. It is behind Smith, the third baseman. Another error from the fielders of Pendleton County. That time it was Dylan Smith. We talked about the wet field earlier in this game.
Number 24, Hayden Jones.
I don't think that had anything to do with the field being wet. That just went behind Smith. Brings up Hayden Jones with two on and two out. And Jones has a pair of base hits in this game and a run scored. Here's a pitch from Kizemore. Misses up high for ball one. That's just deflating if you're the pitcher. Got a 1-2 count, two outs, getting ready to get out of the inning, and an error. Reset your count, reset your batter, and puts another base runner on. And now it's a 2-0 count. Here's the pitch from Kizemore. That one misses, and the throw back to second. Martin was way off of second base, and he gets back just in time. Count is 3-0 to Hayden Jones. A walk right here would load the bases up for Cam Peschel. Two outs. Polar Bears have been incredible this season with two outs. And there it is. Jones walks. Loads the bases up for Cam Peschel, who has a pair of hits in this game. He grounded out in the fourth inning.
Now batting your center fielder, number three, Cam Peschel.
Cam Peschel has 14 hits on the season, leads the entire team. He's the one that can drive in maybe a run, maybe two. That one misses for ball one. That is five consecutive balls thrown by Cashton Kizemore, who is coming in relief for Chase Owens. And now they're going to talk with him on the mound. Returns to their spot. Kizemore trying to get out of this inning without allowing any more runs. Already two have come in for the Polar Bears, Veltri and Whitehair, and now you have Martin, Gorby, and Jones on the bases. Loaded up, two outs, and the batter is Cam Peschel with a 1-0 count. Pitch from Kizemore, that one misses. The count is 2-0. Heschel fouls that one back. Count is 2-1. This will be pitch number 26 for Kizemore, and he hasn't even completed an inning yet. A lot of pitches. Here's the 2-1. That one misses. It's ball three. They try to throw to third to get Martin out. He gets back safely, and it's a 3-1 count for Peschel. Base is loaded, two outs. Here's the 3-1, and Peschel has a base hit and RBI. Martin scores. Here comes Gorby. He's coming to the plate. Throw by Owens is way off. Jones gets to third. Peschel to second. The Polar Bears lead 8-1. And Cam Peschel delivers again.
Now batting your third baseman. Number one,
two RBI single for Peschel, and he gets to second on the bad throw by Owens here. Gorby's safe. Jones is at third. Peschel is at second. Two outs, two on. Sammy Vianney. Kizemore, that one's outside for ball one. Martin came in and scored. Gorby came in and scored. And the thing is, neither of those runs were earned runs. They both off errors by Pendleton County, and they had a chance to end the inning on both of those batters. And an inning that started 4-1, the Polar Bears have doubled their run total. They now lead 8-1, still with two on and two out. Pitch from Kizemore. That is grounded. It's going to be a tough play. Owens fields it. That one's in the air. And he came off the base. Vianney is safe. Jones is in. It's 9-1. He came off the base at the exact time that he needed to be on the base. It was going to be a tough play by Owens. It was Harper, the first baseman. You can see him leap there, and then he tried to make the tag as well. Vianney is safe.
It's all the way up.
So still two on, two out. Vianney is on first. Hayden Jones came in and scored there. Peschel is now at third. If two more runs come in this inning for the Polar Bears, the game's over. Canfield comes to the plate for the Polar Bears. He's already batted in this inning and walked. Veltri, courtesy ran for him, came in and scored. That started the scoring for this inning for the Polar Bears. It was 4-1 coming into the bottom of the fifth. They now lead 9-1. Two on, two outs. It's been the story of this inning. The Polar Bears just keep scoring. Here's the pitch from Kizemore, and Canfield fouls it over down third baseline and out of play. Count is 0-1 to Canfield. The 0-1, and Canfield sends this one into left field. Back is Smith, and he gets under it and makes the catch for the third out, and Pendleton County gets out of the nightmare of the inning. giving up 5 runs, and the score is now 9-1. A Polar Bear lead of 8. Watching live streaming coverage of Polar Bear baseball here on Video Productions.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
An injury at any age can be a game changer, but with walk-in clinics Monday through Saturday, the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute is ready to get you off the bench and back in the game. Marshall Sports Medicine Institute takes care of the herd. Let us take care of you.
I'm Keith Powell, and going on right now is my Keith Says Yes Fest. I'm saying yes to lowering your payments, yes to your trade-in, regardless of condition, miles, even if you're still making payments. My Keith Says Yes credit approval process helps me say yes, you're approved. So if you want new Chevys, yes. New Fords, yes. Lifetime warranty, yes. Come see me, Keith Powell, at Yes Chevy in Hurricane and Yes Ford in Huntington.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park. The Polar Bears have an 8-run lead. The score is 9-1. Getting ready for the top of the 6th inning. Canfield remains on the mound. Only at 68 pitches through 5 innings. That's pretty good. Due up for the Wildcats will be Owens, Vinsel, and Kizemore. Canfield fires that one in the strike zone for strike one to Owens. Chase Owens started on the mound today for Pendleton, got replaced by Kizemore. That one is grounded, tough play by Vianney. He fields it, throw to Jones on a hop, is not in time. A little late, and a base hit there for Chase Owens, his second of the game. Puts a base runner on with nobody out for the Wildcats. Brings up James Vinsel for Pendleton County.
Now batting number 10, James Vinsel.
Canfield fires that one to Vinsel, misses high for ball one. One on, nobody out for the Polar Bears. The count is 1-0. Canfield tries to pick off Owens at first. No avail. He gets back safely. Pitch to Vinsel. That one's in the strike zone. And they try to throw to first. Miller tried to throw to first. And Owens gets back safely again. Stepping back in to the batter's box is Vinsel. Canfield tries to pick off Owens again. Canfield delivers. Owens takes off. Throw by Miller. Not in time. And it's a stolen base for Chase Owens. And here comes talk with Canfield at the mound. He's pitched 5 innings to this point. Starting his 6th, he's had a really good game, 9 strikeouts. And he will be done. So Canfield exits, 5 innings pitched in this one, 9 strikeouts. He's allowed a few hits. Waiting to see who the new pitcher will be for the Polar Bears. And it's going to be, looks like Brock Martin. Wait until everyone clears out to confirm. And yeah, it will be Brock Martin on the mound for the Polar Bears, making his first mound appearance of the season. Transfer from North Marion, playing in just his third game of the year. And he'll begin his warm-up. We'll step away while Martin warms up. You're watching live streaming coverage of Polar Bear Baseball here on Video Productions.
National Bank, where you can purchase or refinance your home with the No Down Payment Champion Mortgage. No down payment, no private mortgage insurance, no kidding. Visit your local branch to get started today. City National Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. To learn more, log on to mortgage.bankatcity.com.
Here at the Cracker Barrel, homestyle food and great value go hand in hand with favorites like slow-simmered chicken and dumplings starting at $7.99. Or perfectly golden fluffy buttermilk pancakes with your own bottle of warm syrup. Come fill up on favorites without emptying your wallet. Cracker Barrel. Take care now.
Little General Stores has been serving West Virginia communities for almost 5 decades. That's nearly 50 years of providing those essential needs for your daily journey. We are so grateful to be a small part of your lives, and we want to recognize the integral part of our operation, the LG family. We know these last couple years haven't been easy, but with every sunrise and sunset, you keep us going. To the LG family, the moms, dads, sisters, brothers, sons, and daughters of West Virginia, thank you.
You have a goal. You know what you want. Start with us, New River Community and Technical College, your community college. Take classes online or in a classroom in Beaver, Lewisburg, Summersville, or Princeton. Or step outside the classroom in one of our technical or health programs. Find flexible and affordable options to help you reach your goal. It's closer than you think when you start with us. New River Community and Technical College. Apply today.
Back at Mary Lou Retton Park, Brock Martin is warmed up and ready. One on, nobody out. The count is 2-1. It's the pitch from Martin, and that one is into center field. Under it is Canfield, and Canfield makes the catch. The throw back to third is not in time. They're going to throw it to second. Is he out? Yes, he is. He left early. It's a double play. And that's a double play there. That's going to end the top of the sixth inning. I thought that was only two outs, but that'll do it. Flipping it to the bottom. Okay. I thought it was two outs. Pendleton County looks like it was two outs. The Polar Bears ran back to the dugout. It's only two outs. It was a double play. There was nobody out. Trying to sort it out. The umpire is over. I was confused for a second because Canfield made the catch in center field and Owens left second early. They tried to throw it to third to pick him off on the tag there. He was not out at third. He wasn't safe, but they threw back to second and they say Owens left early. So the bases are empty with two outs for the Wildcats and just a game filled with mistakes for Pendleton County. Ever since they led 1-0 in the first inning, it's gone downhill fast. So the batter will be Cashton Kizemore. Vinsel flied out there, and then Owens left second early. Didn't make the tag successfully. Results in a double play for the Polar Bears. So Brock Martin has one pitch and resulted in a double play.
Now batting number 16, Cassius Cosmore.
Nobody on, two outs for the Wildcats. Cashton Kizemore will be the batter. Big gust of wind coming through now. Here's the pitch from Martin. Misses barely for ball one. The 1-0 from Martin is down low for ball two. Kizemore grounded out and reached second on an error, dropped in center field by Peschel. 2-0 count from Martin, a swing and a miss by Kizemore. Count is 2-1. The 2-1 catches the strike zone for strike two. The 2-2, up high, and the count is full. Nobody on, two outs for Pendleton County. Here's the payoff pitch. Swing and a miss, and Martin strikes out Kizemore to end the top of the sixth inning. Due up for the Polar Bears. When we return, will be Brody Whitehair, Dylan Hours, and Ethan Miller. You're watching live streaming coverage of Polar Bear Baseball here on Video Productions.
Hi, my name is Zach Frazier, and I'm from Fairmont, West Virginia. And when I'm back at home in Fairmont, you'll find me at my local Parmar store.
We had that Golden Boot Pride at Parmar. There are literally hundreds of Parmar stores in West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, and even more on the way. Download the Parmar app to save even more. And whether it's food, gas, groceries, or whatever, we have you covered at Parmar. West Virginia proud and ready to serve you.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
An injury at any age can be a game changer. But with walk-in clinics Monday through Saturday, the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute is ready to get you off the bench and back in the game. Marshall Sports Medicine Institute takes care of the herd. Let us take care of you.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park, and a massive lineup change for Pendleton County. I'm going to try to get all of these new players, but they've practically replaced every position. Try to go through it. New pitcher will be Will Smith. Catcher will be Noah Lockard. First baseman will be Henry Warner. Second baseman will be Caden Boone. Shortstop will be Cameron Beecher. Third baseman will be Spencer Hartman. I'm trying to catch the numbers of the outfielders for Pendleton, but they've gone all JV. Apologize if I won't say the names of the outfielders. Pendleton switched every position they had. So I got all the infielders. Outfielders, I'm trying to look at their number. I can't see it from here, so go through all the infield changes. Will Smith will be the pitcher. Lefty, Henry Warner will be on first. Caden Boone at second. Cam Beecher at short. And Spencer Hartman at third. Got number three is Jonas Turner at center field. I was able to catch that one. He was walking back to his spot. The batter for the Polar Bears instead of Whitehair will be Slayton Jack. Culver switching their lineup too.
Slayton Jack.
Slayton Jack has two plate appearances on the season, and he has two runs. Only his stats recorded, but those two runs came on being a courtesy runner, not from the plate. Starting the bottom of the sixth inning, the Polar Bears can knock two runs in. They can end it after this inning without having to go to the seventh. As they lead by eight, the rule is 10 runs. After four innings, we'll do it. Here's the pitch from Smith, fouled back by Jack for strike one. Smith deals that one behind Jack. Wild pitch there. Went behind the batter, Slayton Jack. Count is now 1-1. Smith, that one misses and goes to the wall. Ball two. Two teams warming up, getting ready to play on this field will be North Marion and Parkersburg South after this game. Count is 2-1. Will Smith deals up high, ball three. The 3-1 misses, ball four, and Jack is on. He walks.
Now batting number 36. Cooper Keener.
And the batter now for the Polar Bears will be Cooper Keener, freshman, also a football player. Slayton Jack is the base runner on first. Nobody out, one
step
on.
Out. Step out. Step out.
Umpire's not in his spot. Keener was ready. Smith was ready. They were ready to start pitching. And the umpire was not behind home plate. One on, nobody out. The batter is Cooper Keener. The pitcher is Will Smith. Smith deals. That one is grounded by Keener. Could be two. Beecher is just going to throw to first, and it is caught by Warner. One out. And Jack advances to second. Ground out by Keener.
Matt Masters
comes up to the plate now in place of Ethan Miller. And Masters has, this isn't new for him being at the plate. He's got 10 plate appearances, pair of hits, a pair of RBIs, batting 222 on the year. One on and one out. Base runner at second is Slayton Jack. Pitch from Smith. That's behind Masters. Second time that's happened, and Slayton Jack safe at third. So he hasn't hit anyone yet, but he's thrown two pitches behind the batters. It's not often as a batter you have to step up to the plate to miss a pitch and avoid getting hit. Count is 1-0. Smith deals that one, and it's outside in the other batter's box, and the count is 2-0 to Masters. Jack in scoring position trying to drive in the 10th run of the game. If Polar Bears can get two runs in this inning, they can end it without going to the 7th. That one misses and gets behind Lockard. Count is 3-0 to Matt Masters. Trying to avoid a walk here, Will Smith, and he puts it right down the middle for strike one. Makes the count 3-1. Just after 2:30, games lasted a little bit over 2 hours. We're in the bottom half of the sixth inning. Polar Bears lead 9-1. That one is grounded foul by Masters, and the count is full. One on and one out. Count is full. Smith steps back on the mound. Slayton Jack is the base runner at third. One on, one out. Here's the payoff pitch. Misses ball four and Masters walks. He takes his base. Two on, one out. Up to the plate now is Braden Sharps. Place of Brock Martin. Sharps making his first plate appearance of the season. Got runners on the corners with only one out. Sharps, left-handed batter, trying to drive in a run right here. Pitch from Smith in the dirt for ball one. Masters the base runner at first. Slayton Jack the base runner at third. The pitch from Smith. Swung on and fouled back by Sharp. Count is 1-1. Only one out still in the bottom of the sixth inning. Polar Bears have Slayton Jack in scoring position trying to notch their 10th run of the game. Braden Sharps sees it, swings and misses. Strike two. On deck for the Polar Bears is Tanner Eddy. Polar Bears do have a game later today, so they are saving their players. Here's the pitch. That one called strike three, and Sharps strikes out looking for the second out of the inning, and that'll bring up Tanner Eddy. Masters is at second. Was able to get to second there. It's two on, two outs, two in scoring position. If these two runners can come in, the game will be over. Here's the pitch from Smith. That one misses low for ball one. On deck for the Polar Bears will be Blake Strait. Eddie making his first plate appearance of the season. Pitch from Smith. Inside, gets by. Here comes Jack to the plate. He's in. It's 10-1. Slayton Jack scores on the wild pitch. Matt Masters gets to third. And the Polar Bears are one run away from becoming 9-1 on the season. And Eddie has a 2-0 count in favor of him. Masters the base runner at third. Here's the pitch. That gets by. Masters didn't take off. That would have won the game. Lockard couldn't locate it in time. The count's now 3-0 to Eddie. Masters isn't known for his speed, but he would have been able to get there. Here's the 3-0. Swung and fouled back by Eddie off the roof of the press box and drops down. Counts 3-1. Pitch from Smith, the 3-1, that misses, and Eddie will take his base. Runners on the corners with two outs again, brings up straight. Now Blake Straight could be the one that could send home the run that'll win the Polar Bears the game. They're up by 9. If they're up by 10 by the end of this inning, it'll end early due to the 10-run mercy rule. And Pendleton is deciding to switch pitchers. The new pitcher will be number 34, which is Henry Warner. So he moves from first to the mound. Fourth pitcher of the game for the Wildcats. We're going to step aside while Warner warms up, watching live streaming coverage of Polar Bear Baseball here on Video Productions.
Since 1965, the team at City Construction has been an industry leader in all facets of construction, shaping the West Virginia landscape with some of the most recognizable commercial projects throughout the state. As one of the largest general contractors in North Central West Virginia, our outstanding record of quality workmanship and personal service is here for your next project. Call our team of experts today.
Give us the opportunity to design and build your next project. City Construction Company, West Virginia proud since 1965.
Here at the Cracker Barrel, homestyle food and great value go hand in hand with favorites like slow simmered chicken and dumplings starting at $7.99 or perfectly golden fluffy buttermilk pancakes with your own bottle of warm syrup. Come fill up on favorites without emptying your wallet. Cracker Barrel, take care now.
City National Bank, where you can purchase or refinance your home with the No Down Payment Champion Mortgage. No down payment, no private mortgage insurance, no kidding. Visit your local branch to get started today. City National Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. To learn more, log on to mortgage.bankatcity.com.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
Welcome back to Mary Lou Retton Park, where the Polar Bears lead the Wildcats 10-1. Pendleton County has switched to their fourth pitcher of the game. It is Henry Warner. He moved from first to the mound, and Will Smith moved from the mound to first base. The only fielding changes I saw there, the batter will be Straight.
Now batting number 11. Straight.
Runners on the corners. Masters is the base runner at third. Tanner Eddy is the base runner at first. If one run comes in, the game will end after this inning. Here's the pitch from Warner. Misses high for ball one to Straight. Here's the 1-0. Swung on, grounded, and that is a foul ball that would have ended the game if it was fair, but a curve foul at the last second makes the count 1-1. Straight making his 20th plate appearance on the season. He has 4 hits, 3 runs, and a pair of RBIs, batting 240. The 1-1. Misses inside for ball two. Two-one count for Strait. Here's the pitch from Warner. Swung on and straight. This is into left field. And it is down. This game is over. Strait wins it. Here comes Eddie. Eddie's going to come all the way home, too. Two runs are in on a two RBI double. And that ends it. The game is over. The last run, I don't believe, will count. All they needed was 10. It's 11-1. The final score from Mary Lou Retton Park. The Polar Bears score 11 unanswered runs after trailing 1-0 in the first to win and improve to 9-1 on the season. Post-game wrap-up coming up next. You're watching live streaming coverage of Polar Bear Baseball here on Video Productions.
Sandwiches, better with Pepsi.
An injury at any age can be a game changer. But with walk-in clinics Monday through Saturday, the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute is ready to get you off the bench and back in the game. Marshall Sports Medicine Institute takes care of the herd. Let us take care of you.
I'm Keith Powell, and going on right now is my Keith Says Yes Fest. I'm saying yes to lowering your payments, yes to your trade-in, regardless of condition, miles, even if you're still making payments. My Keith Says Yes credit approval process helps me say yes, you're approved. So if you want new Chevys, yes. New Fords, yes. Lifetime warranty, yes. Come see me, Keith Powell, at Yes Chevy in Hurricane and Yes Ford in Huntington.
Back at Mary Lou Retton Park, where the Polar Bears have won. They 10-run the Wildcats of Pendleton County, 11-1, the final score. We'll go through the scoring recap real quick. Alden Rexrode was the first run to score for either team. He came in the first inning for the Wildcats, and after that for Pendleton County, they didn't score. Polar Bears, however, they scored 11 times. Peschel came in the first inning. Then Peschel came in again in the third inning. Jones scored in the third. Braden Gorby scored in the fourth inning. Tyler Veltri scored as a courtesy runner for Canfield in the fifth. Whitehair scored in the fifth. Brock Martin scored in the fifth. Braden Gorby scored in the fifth. Hayden Jones scored in the fifth. Went to the sixth inning where Matt Masters came in and scored, and that was the winning run. Tanner Eddy also came in and scored, so I'll have to check. The score could either be 11 or 12-1 because they both scored on the same play. So the Polar Bears have won this one 11-1. We'll take a look at the upcoming schedule. They play here later today against the Patriots of Parkersburg South. We will not be covering that game live, unfortunately, but it will be a home game for the Polar Bears at 5 o'clock against Parkersburg South. They'll be back after that on Monday at Robert C. Byrd. And then we'll be here Tuesday, a big game against regional rival, the Kaiser Golden Tornadoes, at 5 o'clock on Tuesday. That will be live streamed. Then they're at Bridgeport, another huge rivalry. That's at 4:30 on Thursday. And then they've got a doubleheader on the road against Berkeley Springs and Frankfort on Saturday. So that's the upcoming schedule for the Polar Bears of Fairmont Senior. For Pendleton County, they started the season off 6-0. They dropped four of their last five. They now are 7-4 on the season. The Polar Bears improved to 9-1. It's a good game here at Mary Lou Retton Park. Warming up now will be Park South and North Marion are playing. We're going to cut the live stream. You've been watching live streaming coverage of Polar Bear Baseball here on Video Productions. The Polar Bears are 9-1 on the season. They have won over Pendleton County. We'll see you on